Hey Internet, my name is Abby and welcome back to Buzz Aldrin Space Program Manager. As a reminder, episode 100 is coming up and my idea is to do another interview with Ignacio, and I like to do it a little bit in the interactive way. So if you're interested in having an additional interview with Ignacio in the 100th episode of my Let's Play series, then please leave me a message. And additionally, I like to discuss your questions. So if you have a question for Ignacio, just send in these questions to me and I will try my very best to discuss them with Ignacio and to give you hopefully an amazing show and some additional insights into the development of the Space Program Manager. This would be really amazing. And now, enough of the idea of talking about of the 100th episode. Now it's time to test out... not to test out, because we do have some scientists left over, but I'm currently not sure. Is there anything I can research? Well, the three crew ballistic capsule unfortunately needs some time, because we need to wait for astronauts. Only two crew. Well, of course, the LK-700 needs some time, because we just ruined it. Soyuz 7KL-1 Earth Orbit. I think we haven't done this. So let me open up this program. Yep, very good. Program successfully opened. Then we can start researching this program as well. Soyuz, where is the Soyuz spacecraft? I do have a lot of components currently being opened because I'm waiting for the new animations added to the game so that I do not need to reopen them. In this case here, I can now start researching the Soyuz 7KL-1 and back. Okay, we are now researching, and now let's end the season. Very nice. And yeah, the LK-700 needs some time after we screwed it up again. Mars M69 is on its final season. The other missions need some time. Luna 2 needs some time. The Soyuz spacecraft needs also some time. Okay, and let's resume the mission, followed from mission control, and hopefully we can finish the Mars M69. Because yeah, new animations are always great. It's beeping. It's a success! Yeah, well done, well done. We finished the next new set of animations. This was just great. This was really just great. Okay, mapping of the surface of Mars level 2, study of the surface and atmosphere of Mars level 2. Very nice, very nice. Okay, we finished this, we can close it. And now it's time for us to launch this mission. Okay, let's take off. Hey, this is cool. This is really cool. It's a huge plane. And the music is so great. The new Soviet music is just amazing. Okay, chance of success 87.5. Problem solved. Good job. This is cool. This is just great. Okay, another problem. 87.5. Problem solved. Good job, guy. Good job. Oh, his leadership, piloting, and fitness skill level is quite low. Compared to being quite high in the skill level as I assigned him. But yeah, well done, well done. Good job, good flight. This was amazing, this was amazing. And the music, and the new music is just great, and the new Soviet sound effects. This really adds some new dimension to the missions. This is just great. This makes a lot of fun to watch this. Okay. So we finished our M69. And we also finished the space plane again. Very nice, very nice. Okay, now we can clean up a little bit our open programs. We do not need any more of the Mars M69, and we do not need no longer the PK space plane. Yes, I want to remove this. Now we do have four scientists left over. And do I have something? I think I've opened up all the satellites. Yes, I have. What else? Mars is done. Moon. Have we something missing on the moon? I think we did the Zond 5 already, have I? We did the Luna 3. Have I done the Zond 5? Can I see somewhere the reliability of this program? Think I have to open up this. Yeah, let's open up the thing. Have I done this already? No, I haven't. Okay, let's research the Zond 5. Okay. So, manage payload. Zond 5, where are you? Zond 5, okay. Let's add some scientists to it. Okay, very good. So, what's next? I don't think that the satellites, the Kerbal Sputnik 2 and the Sputnik 2 have already animations, so I will keep them in place and ready to be launched once animations are implemented. So we can now continue with our Soyuz LOK, because now we do have an astronaut ready, so we can, yeah, let's try this with the N1 booster. Hopefully the N1 booster is now creating also the launch sequences. And yeah, okay, let's assign our best candidates. Very good. Mission is scheduled. We never have 14 flight controllers left over. Let me just check again my components. Can I schedule something else? Venera 9? No. Mars 2? No. Sputnik 2? No. Luna 50? No. Luna 2? No. Nothing. Nothing else. Okay. So, in this case, let's end the season and let's continue. Okay, LK700 still needs some time, and I assume all the other things haven't reached a good point so that we can launch them. No, they haven't. Okay, let's proceed on so that we can do the uncrewed orbital flight test, followed from mission control. Okay, loading in the mission data, and here we go. What we do have too. N1 booster, but yeah, now, speaking of N1 booster, now it's working. Now we are having even the animations for the launch process. This is just amazing. And look at this huge booster. Well, it's not so crazy like the LK700 booster, but wow, look at this pyramid. This is amazing. Okay, booster separation, well done. Fairing separation, wow. This was a huge fairing. Okay, orbit insertion. This is amazing. And together with this great music. The music is just amazing. This is so great. Wow. Oh, and we have a look out of the window. Okay, now we need to prepare to return back home. Deorbit burn. This is cool. Okay. Descent. Descent. A success. Amazing. Amazing. And let's recover our spacecraft. Also a success. Well done. Well done. Okay, this was great. This was great. Seeing the N1 booster for the very first time was just amazing. This was really cool. I like this. Okay, we have a small upgrade for our components because, well, oh no, Alexei Yaromoluk is again unhappy. We need to send him again to advanced training, but no, our astronauts are back from advanced training and also from basic training, so now we have a lot of astronauts ready to continue our missions. This is amazing. Okay, in this case, should I risk to try two launches at the same time? Yeah, let's risk this, let's risk this. I haven't lost any men in the last time, and after I'm now sure that this is mostly due to the fact of the random number generator between with the 100-sided dice, I just risk this now. At first, yeah, let's schedule a suborbital flight. We want to see a crewed suborbital flight. Let's proceed on, let's assign our best flight controllers. And yeah, let's assign Yuri Bobrik and Yevgeny Kalturin to our mission. Very good, very good. Okay, and let's try this. Let's risk this. We want to do also Soyuz 7K L3 allocate the orbital flight. We want to do the orbital flight. Let's assemble the thing. Let's start the assembly process and let's add all of our candidates. Very good. And our new pilots. Very good, very good. So, and then we do have some astronauts left over and we have some flight controllers left over. Right. Speaking of flight controllers, we can test one thing. Do we have enough for the Kerbal Sputnik 2? Oh, we need 10 flight controllers. Okay, and yeah, the other Sputnik is still in development, so we can't use them, but I can assign one of my flight controllers to advanced training. No, this way are the scientists again. No, let's try this again. 45. We need to find someone with a moral of 45 to send him to advanced training. Where is he? 100, 100. Do we have another page? No. Or is he now assigned to a project? Maybe he's assigned to a project. This could be also the reason. Okay. Well, maybe he's assigned to a project. Very good. Okay, let's move on. Let's move on. Two launches in a row. 76 for the LK-700. 78 Venera. The Mars lander. Soyuz. Nothing is getting close to be ready to be launched. No. Okay. So, suborbital flight. Do you want? Yes, of course I want. Because I want to see the new great animations. Again, another N1 booster, and yes, the N1 booster seems to be the appropriate one even for the suborbital launches. Oh, up there is a moon, there was a moon. We had a visual on the moon, this is great, okay. And yeah, this booster is really amazing. And yeah, as I said, I can just repeat myself, the LK-700 booster is much even more crazy, but yeah, this thing is still pretty cool. Okay, here we go with our two new cosmonauts. The music is really dramatic. This is just great. This is so great. I think just for the ambience I like to stay on the Soviet side because it sounds really, really much better. Currently for me, for my ears, than the NASA side. But maybe we will have there also a specific and NASA music theme or something like this. This would be also cool. But currently the Russian side is really amazing. Okay, here comes our Soyuz capsule and we have a successful landing. Hopefully we can recover our crew. Yeah, a success. Well done, well done. 850 prestige points earned. Not bad, not bad at all. And we need to check. Has our crew... Yeah, even the crew has increased a small upgrade of about, well, 3% and 202%. This is not bad. And our orbital flight. Let's launch this. Yes, of course, we want to monitor this from the mission control. And let's see. Okay, this time the skill level of the cosmonauts is quite low. But I hope they will learn something, or they will screw up right away the mission. 79%, problem solved, okay. Wow, a random number of 96. This is cool, this is really cool. Okay. Random number 87, wow. I'm really lucky this time with the random numbers. And with some more successful missions, I will even increase the skill level of my guys and my cosmonauts, so that they get better at what they are doing. This is just cool. The fairing separation is just amazing. Okay, spacecraft deployment was a success. Amazing, good job. Earth orbit is a success and a view out of the window. Okay, now we need to return back home. And now, what will I do next? I never have again enough astronauts or cosmonauts to continue with the Soyuz 7K. Okay, I don't know, the three-man capsule. I was stuck there because I was running out of astronauts. Maybe I should continue with this, at least given the fact that now my cosmonauts will survive. Problem solved. Okay, and a random number of 28. Ooh, this was close. Okay, so maybe I should try out again the three crew capsule. Maybe this will work better. Ooh, chance of success and minor glitch. Okay, the random numbers are decreasing. Okay, so well done, well done. Good job, good job. Okay, we had two successful missions in a row. This is completely new. This is great. This is great. Okay, very nice. Okay, we had two successful missions and we have a budget increase. Well, we have enough money, so I don't think that we will run out of money. But we are here to test out. Yeah, the 7K, okay. We are here to test out the new animations, because this is all what matters right now. And now we got stuck. I think we finished the EVA, right? Yeah, we finished the EVA. But we are now stuck with the joint launch and orbital flight, right? I guess so. I think we haven't completed this, so in this case, let me schedule this, assemble now. Yeah, I have already read this, I can remember this. Let's assign all of our best candidates to this. And let's assign all of our pilots. I hope they will return back alive and level up a little bit. Okay, I have six Hey, wait, I can do the one thing. I can see if there is already an animation for the Kerbal Sputnik 2. Let's use the proton rocket for this. Sputnik 2, biosatellite, study of Earth's magnetic field, study of microgravity on small living organisms. Okay, let's assemble this. This mission involves the launch and deployment in Earth orbit of a Vostok spacecraft equipped to carry a biological payload, which consists in two dogs, 40 mice, two rats and a variety of plants. Two cameras can send back television pictures of the dogs, who are equipped with biometric sensors which transmit their vital parameters to the ground stations. This mission lasts one day, at the end of which the spacecraft lands in Soviet territory, I assume. Okay, let's proceed on. Let's assign our best candidates to this. I hope they will bring back our test animals alive. Okay, we have two missions scheduled. Let's move on. And 78, okay. 79, 69, 81. Oh, the Sputnik 2 is ready to go, but I think I haven't read anything about the animations for the Sputnik 2, so I don't think we need to launch this. Okay, this time, joint launch and orbital flight. Will we be successfully this time? Will we have a successful launch? I hope so, I hope so. Okay, loading in the mission. And yeah, this time, on a Soyuz booster. And let's hope, let's keep fingers crossed that we are lucky with our random numbers. That not the random numbers are killing again my cosmonauts I've just hired and just trained. Okay, launch. The launch is a success. And the Soyuz rocket is looking really small compared to the huge M1 booster or the huge LK-700 booster. Okay, fairing separation, very nice. And let's insert our first spacecraft into orbit. And here, spacecraft deployment was a success. Very nice, very nice. And we are in Earth orbit. This is great. Okay, a success. Very nice, very nice. And there is the fake spacecraft again. And no. Launch preparations for the second spacecraft for today. Or for this launch. The countdown is going on. And a success. Very good, very good. Here we go. Oh, one of the cosmonauts is at 41%. Oh, this is not good. I hope the flight controllers can fix this if he's screwing something up, he, she. Okay, ascent. We are currently in step 11. Okay, spacecraft B, orbit insertion. Until now, everything is okay. And spacecraft deployment. Okay. Okay, now this would make sense because now we do have two Sputnik in... No, not Sputnik. What is this? Two Soyuz in... Joint flight. Success. Oh, this is all? This was all? Oh, okay, okay. I thought there would be more of parallel flight or anything like this, but this was still cool. This was really cool. Okay, and finally we can make some progress with our Soyuz 7KOK space program, that we can finally make our way through the new animations. This is just great. And I think afterwards we will have, what was this, rendezvous, docking or something? Oh no, we have a problem. 94.3, problem solved, and another low random roll. But yeah, it's okay. When I compare this to the chances, then this was quite okay. What? This was all? And what about the second spacecraft? Three cosmonauts returned. What about the spacecraft B? Or is this a two-season mission configuration? I am confused. I am confused. Okay. Curable Sputnik 2. Follow from mission control. And let's see if we do have some animations. Well, at least we do have the animations for the Proton rocket. This is nice. And I think we do have also the animations for the Vostok spacecraft, so maybe we have only a placeholder for the spacecraft deployment. Okay, but countdown was a success, this is good. And unfortunately we do not have here the great new dramatic Soviet music. This time it's completely silent. The ascent is a success, hopefully. Yeah, it is. Very nice, very nice. And spacecraft deployment. Oh, we do have even a... well, some kind of placeholder, because we do not see a spacecraft on top. I think this is a frigate upper stage. And there is our Vostok spacecraft. Yeah, well done. We do have the animations for this mission. This is good. This is great. This is great. Okay, now we are returning. And retrofire. Oh, we have a problem. We do have a problem. Chances of success 80%. Problem solved. 50 per a random number of 50. Not bad. Not bad. Okay. We are now falling back home with our dogs and mice and rats and... wait, what? Okay, we have ejected some kind of dummy or some kind of cosmonaut, but we had on board our dogs and so on. Okay, but well, this was nice. But now I'm Kerbal Sputnik 2 biosatellite. Study of the Earth's magnetic field. Study of microgravity on small living organisms. Very nice, very nice. This was great. And yeah, good job, guys. Good job. Okay, the joint launch and orbital flight was a successful mission, and we do not have any information about this, that the mission is still going on, and we do have all our flight controllers back. So in this case, I really assume that the mission is just over, okay? This is interesting, this is really interesting. We can get rid of another configuration of the Kerbal Sputnik 2. Yeah, let's close this program. And then I want to schedule Soyuz 7K, okay. The automatic rendezvous. Let's add two Soyuz boosters to it. Let's schedule the mission. This mission involves the launch of two crewed spacecraft and can, if well planned, last less than 12 hours. The second spacecraft is launched 90 minutes after the first, which allows to be placed on a similar orbit. Once in position, the second spacecraft uses its maneuvering engine to adjust its orbit and perform rendezvous and station keeping within several meters of the first spacecraft. This maneuver requires a functional IGLA automated rendezvous system. The two spacecraft then deorbit and land one after another, I assume. Okay, let's assign our best candidates. Where is our Capcom? Nikolai Zaitsev, I think he was the one who did the test flight with the EPKA space plane as we had the drop test. And now let's assign our best candidates. They have hopefully improved a little bit over the last mission. And unfortunately, we are at the end of today's episode. I hope you liked this, and I hope you will be joining me in the next episode when we continue with our space program. In this case, thank you so much for watching. Until next time, my name is Abby. See you!